You might notice that this graph here is not called Luma curve, it's actually called RGB curves. And that's because we've got these three other curves over here, a red curve, a green curve, and a blue curve, so RGB. And let me tell you, these curves have saved my footage when my white balance was off. And you know, it's easy sometimes for your white balance to get off if your camera settings weren't perfect, or maybe there's some weird colored lighting around you, and you're gonna end up with an image where the white stuff doesn't actually look white. And sometimes this little white balance section up here in basic correction is a little too basic, and it is not powerful enough to always fix the situation. And that is where these RGB curves are gonna come in clutch and save your behind. So the reason that these are so good for white balance is because when you mix red, green, and blue, you end up with white. This phenomenon is called additive color. Don't ask me how it works, okay? Look, we've got formulations and algebraic equations and photons, and y'all, this is too much for me, but just trust me, when you mix red, green, and blue, you get white. But the key here is that those colors need to be in equal amounts. Once your RGB levels are unequal, your white is no longer white and you've got white balance issues. But that is okay, because there is a scope in Premiere that's going to help us fix the situation. So this scope is going to show us the red, green, and blue levels for our shots so that we can make sure they're even, especially near the brightest points of our shot where things should be white. This scope is called RGB parade because it shows the red, green, and blue levels in our shot through waveforms that are lined up one after the other like they're in a parade. So to see this chart, make sure that you right click in the Lumetri Scopes panel, and then you're gonna go to parade type and then select RGB. And up at the top, you wanna make sure that parade RGB is checked to show the scope. And I'm gonna uncheck all the other scopes so that nothing else is in view. All right, now when the white balance in a shot looks good, these three waveforms should be pretty even, especially up near the top near the white pixels in the shot. But if we go to a shot that has too much green in it, let's say, then if we look back at this RGB parade, you will see that that green waveform is way higher than the red and the blue one, right? So to fix this, we're gonna use these RGB curves here in the Lumetri color panel. So I'm just gonna go to my green curve here, and I'm gonna lower that brightest end until I see the waveforms in the RGB parade getting more even. And so now you can see our shot is looking so much better. I mean, if we look at the before shot, these people were looking sickly, and now we've got them looking like normal humans. Another cool trick when you're fixing the white balance of your shot is you can go into the effects panel and you can add a crop effect to your image. And then you can use that to crop everything out in your shot except for an area that should be white but isn't. Then under the crop effect, you can click this zoom button here, and that is going to blow up that area that should be white on your screen, and it makes it really easy to look at our RGB parade in Lumetri Scopes to see exactly how our white balance is off here. So then we just click on the colors in the RGB curves in the Lumetri color panel, and we adjust those top right points until our waveforms line up over in the RGB parade. And so now, after we did that, you will see that our white area is actually looking white now. And so we'll delete that crop effect. And now if we look at the before of our entire image and we look at the after, you'll see how those RGB curves in the RGB parade totally fixed the white balance of this shot.
You've been watching an excerpt of The Color Lesson, which is my online course where I teach you color correction and grading in Adobe Premiere Pro and how to work Lumetri Color and Lumetri Scopes so that you can give your video all the vibes. If you're interested in learning more, you can visit marybetsy.com/colorlesson.